Hello, and today I wanted to talk to you guys about motion controlling consoles, because as of a few days ago, Sony's PlayStation Move became available to the masses. So now it's not just Nintendo in the motion gaming console game anymore. Now we have Sony with their entry into that world, and it's the first really high-powered, high-graphics entry into that. So I wanted to talk about it, and specifically how it's going to relate to Project Natal, which is the motion-controlling offering by Microsoft that's coming out later this year. I should note, I didn't realise this when I said it just a few minutes ago, I just forgot, but it's not Project Natal anymore. That was its code name. It's actually now called Kinect. So I should tell you that I haven't used either of these technologies. I have used the Wii, however, so I'm just going to give them my general opinions on what is offered by both companies and what I think will be more successful. So let's get ahead. Let's get down to it. First, I think we should start off with a rundown of both the technologies. Kinect is based on a solely webcam structure, so there's no controller. Everything is sensed by a webcam movement on your body, and everything is tracked by a webcam, whereas the PlayStation Move uses a combination of a controller which kind of looks like an ice cream cone coupled with a high definition camera to kind of get the best of both worlds, being the Nintendo Wii Motion Plus kind of thing with the controller, and also the Kinect type of thing with the camera. So my first kind of initial thing with that is, how is the responsiveness of the Kinect going to be affected by light? And really, that's a question that a lot of people can't answer thus far, because it hasn't really been out in the world yet. But the PlayStation Move has, and the PlayStation Move seems to be responding particularly well. It offers true one-to-one motion, and it really seems to respond well. There's some very fun Wii Sports Resort type games that come with it, and also some high graphics games. One key thing about all this is that the Wii was aimed squarely at a family-oriented, childish, standard-def type games, whereas the Xbox and the PS3 in particular are aimed at kind of more hardcore gamers. So this opens up motion controlling to kind of more serious games, maybe future Call of Duty type games, and even with the PlayStation Move there comes a sword fighting game in conjunction with your regular Wii Sports Resort type game. So in conclusion, I like the PlayStation Move. I'm not sure what kind of longevity it's going to have and what kind of future the motion control gaming console is going to have, because I think hardcore gamers are always going to prefer a physical controller, especially compared to a camera-only system, because a camera-only system can be affected by light, it won't be responsive, and you'll probably look like an idiot when you're playing. Enough people already get hand injuries playing with the Wii, so I can't imagine what's going to be like with this. Kinect is going to be an add-on for current Xboxes that's going to run, I believe, about $170 to plug into current Xboxes or last gen Xboxes when the USB port on them, current gen Xboxes are already going to have Kinect support built in, so that will be nice. I think what's really going to clinch this motion controlling war is who is able to get more adult type games ported over to motion controlling units, because as I said, the Wii is kind of aimed squarely at the children's market, and I don't think there's much longevity in that. The Wii has been a very portable console, but I'm just not sure how long that's going to last in the months and years to follow. So those are just my thoughts on the Sony PlayStation Move versus the Microsoft Kinect, indeed versus the Wii Motion Plus. So I want to hear what you think. Please leave a comment. Like this video if you did. If you want to find more content, you can go to my website, tom-rogers.com. And yeah, thanks for watching this, guys. I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.